senle tosisi konu yapotti. Dene tepame gi dantonje gene en lamina jerman nas.
So first examine your minds and try to get rid of any other afflictive emotion or negative thoughts and try to give rise to devotion, faith, inclination, and in that way then just we will carry through the Guru Yoga prayers. So with a very sincere mind and from one's core of heart that do the supplication prayers. So all these practices, whatever we are doing here during the retreat time, is everything revealed out by Treasurer Revealer Trukpa Menchur Dorje. The actual history or story about the Trukpa Menchur Dorje is before the Shakyamuni Buddha's time, that there was a king called Akara, and during that time then he was a son of the king, and he went to collect some jewels from the ocean, and in that way somehow he had to wander around. So then as he was wandering around, then he have a kind of just a net of a cloth that somehow which he carry with him. So then he is actually just looking for that guru named Apara, that which has been looking for a while, and since he was a great Mahasiddha and just wandering, so could not find him for a while. And then one time this guru, master, that Apara, he knew that this son of the king is coming, so then he just wait in certain place.
Then tata jarvipo tela jan zara de kundu zara basegi yore o de avalan je undu avala lanson manche machine.
So then this son of the king, since he is carrying that kind of net called Darapa, so that is why he is also named as Darapa. And then when he met with his master Apara, he didn't know that was the Apara, so he asked, you know, where is Apara? And then instantly this Master Apara kind of flew from there, and then just went on a rock where he just left a footprint, and he started staying there. So then instantly this Zapara also really just developed so much devotion, and then he went there and started receiving teachings.
Deni darabaung te truba tawaris.
And then as he received all those teaching and based on his practice, then he got accomplishment.
And then
Dharapa also have so many disciples. And then there have about three main kind of masters who have great miraculous activities.
And then
being in India, just also reborn several times. And then when Shakyamuni Buddha just attaining enlightenment in India, at that time then he was born as just a Kungao. And then Kungao, he just contains all the Buddha's teaching and has maintained Buddha's teaching for a while. So then later when Guru Padmasambhava came to Tibet, at that time then he was born as a great yogi known as Shubhupal Gesenge, and then he also helped Guru Padmasambhava's activity, such as translating all the just teaching from India to that Sanskrit to Tibetan, and then also just bringing tantric texts and teachings to Tibet. So this Tugu Menjur Dorje have about 500 different lifetimes. So then for a long time he had been manifesting in six realms and benefiting all those sentient beings, and especially being in hell, and lots and lots of hell beings were got liberated. So when he just traveled to hell realm, of course, you know, he don't have any experience of suffering of the hell. Based on his power and realization, he just benefit and liberate all those beings from the hell. And he emptied, got empty many of the hell kind of places. Sometimes that based on the sentient beings of in the hell being very strong karma, and then could not help, then he just do mantra on the scent, and then threw in the fire, and that he extinguished the fire, and then get benefited those beings. And also that he manifested in the animal realm, just such as very tiny, such as like insects, and then huge animals, you know, all other big body and birds and so forth. And then according to their own family that started giving teachings, and that way lots of animal beings were got benefited and liberated.
Then they just purge such a mums that you know, Kusha givers.
And then later in Tibet, there is a place called Ngam, where he was born. So when he is just about 3 years old, he started giving teachings, but then his parents didn't allow him and just saying, what kind of ghost language you are talking about? And then when he was about 11 years old, then of course Changme Rinpoche, his master, knew that he is a special being, and then he invited to his place. So then Changme Rinpoche's kind of relative who was a very negative guy, so that Minju Dorje was there for a while, and that somehow just have a little bit of obscured his mind.
Then Changme Rinpoche chusor nong, oh then the mumbo nong the kudu na par song ne, then they all latam the kya zile, chusong tata nong chidin the Rinpoche no pavares.
So then the Changme Rinpoche gave him lots of purification nectar for a while, and through that those obscurations were got purified, and then later he could have all this clear vision about so many deities, and that is how all these Namche teachings are got revealed out. So then Changme Rinpoche just started teaching him all these scripts and so forth, that Minju Dorje told that, well, I know all those, you know, scripts. And then Changme Rinpoche, he asked to Changme Rinpoche, he wrote many different countries script, and then you know just asked to Changme Rinpoche, do you know this? And then he said, I don't know.
No, then this then it is Changme Rinpoche Dumbo Gagan no Shuma, then Changme Rinpoche Minju Dorje Lama Tenle, then Nachi Tongji Tenla Pap Tenle Numbers.
So that in the beginning, Changme Rinpoche was the Tugu Minju Dorje's master, and then later, when Tugu Minju Dorje started revealing out all this Namche cycle of, you know, teaching, and then Changme Rinpoche just took him as his master, and then through that whole complete revelation of Namche cycle of teachings are being revealed out in that way. So that is why this Namche is the exact Dharma teaching according to the time, that which is kind of very condensed word and profound meanings, and also have the great deal of blessing.
Kila, then it Sonji Kunyangan and David, you said Kila, D Jasa today, numbers over Sonji Zeba, what then the major doji known Gonlo Joji Jokutan, you may humor.
So in that way, being just did lots of benefit here, and then somehow somewhere in another Buddha field, that that Buddha is being going to pass away in Nirvana, and then as a kind of representative there, and also to attain enlightenment, and because of that, then he need to just go there. So he lived only about 19 years on this earth. So that whole complete revelation of this Namche from Changme Rinpoche and then Rinzin Gunsa Sherab till now, that who is the actual kind of, you know, the lineage holders. So many countless were become great Mahasiddhas, and also that it has been explained there would be like 100 million masters who are honored with the that banner.
Tata. Dorje Lobes Lama Kone Yang Tamji Gumba Zunru Dong Damera Yeva Shara Shung Rima to Degas Shigamas.
So that all those Lama who have the Bajara Acharya that the what's the rank, that most of them, when they just, you know, pass away, they all have great signs.
So
same like that, you all guys also being following this tradition and practice. So if you also just think properly and do the practice, then the same kind of blessing is also
there. So
according to that tradition, that starting from the Ngondo Four Foundation all the way to the great perfection, Dzogchen Chekche meditation practice, what we have been just going through.
So that this
Dharma teaching itself is inconceivably profound. And then if you have your own devotion, inclination and faith in this, you know, Dharma, and could do proper practice, then even one may could not have great deal of signs of realization or miraculous activity, but at least, you know, just one could, one may not scared of just dying. So all the disciples, those who engage into this Dharma practice, the most important part is that having the devotion and then the pure perceptions.
So
Right now, that where we mainly concentrating on the Guru Yoga practice, it is because that until we attain complete enlightenment, till to that one must have to rely upon the master, and that is why we are just paying more attention on it. And then, of course, there are many other teachings in relation with the generation completion stage, that not necessarily you could just, you know, understand everything and maybe sometimes get confused with it. So So even though I don't have any experience or kind of realizations or whatever it is, but that I have received all these instructions from my master, and that all everything is in a kind of more just accomplished state.
Na cherong so dyo namba gendu dong so chu ju da da hye du ba cherong to ni ma ne ba se le nyang so le te ba chi.
So that is why that all these teachings, instructions, whatever you have received, then you always all the time try to carry through practice properly.
Ni ten den do ni sang no hyu che mo khum ma de me pen do ga ye ma.
Don't pay so much attention on this present life, because there is no real much benefit. With the intention of liberating and leading all the sentient beings to enlightenment, and then from core of one's heart try to carry through the practice of the Dharma. So as in this, all this phenomena by its nature, it is the emptiness, and from the emptiness the samsara and nirvana phenomena arise, and so don't just have a impure perception. If one understands the interdependent nature, anything can be possible. So as explained before, that when we think of emptiness, then just kind of not having any thought or not having any idea, something like a completely voidness, should not, you know, just understand in that way. So the nature of the phenomena and nature of the mind, it is emptiness, and since everything is emptiness in nature, that is why all everything just arises. So that the nature of emptiness is the appearance, and the appearance nature is the emptiness. So that is why appearance and emptiness are non-dual. It is not like a separate identity. So these all are, it is within one's base of one's mind, and nothing is there in the external. And then have that devotion and inclination, and then we'll do the rest of it. All the time just maintain very positive discipline, that is also important.
And
when I was in Tibet, that where I studied all this Dharma, my teacher Khenpo Nyidin. And he was a great Dzogchen master.
Then
we received the transmission on that text called Dubado, which he has composed, where there is about 4 volumes.
So,
and we were 5 of who are receiving this dharma.
And 그걸 제목에 계획이 들어왔지 남이 뒤로 망가라듯이 나서 뉴이어스.
So we all try to maintain the disciplines, being very humble and respectful, and not just disturbing the lama's mind.
Today, 나서다니 영사 나서로마든 캠보지아스.
And then among us we have another Kempo.
그럼 대지 로마보 전기기절이.
And then this Kempo normally have always lots of coughing.
근데 그럼 로제온이 다바 로마보 전기기.
So he's most of time always having some kind of cough always.
나도 노즈다 주전기 미안 로운데. 그거봐 강아 등으로 노마틸이 강아 등하면서.
So then morning we used to have the classes and then to start that then there is the gong or just normally they ring but one morning then there is nobody is ringing the gong.
나도 야 라미 유셨 예전에 야숨이.
So anyhow we went nearer to the lama's place.
강아등을 강아미도 가시 이제 집안에.
And then we asked that, oh, there, why that there is not ringing the gong?
Lama, the gong sound, the kangadum gisungdusit.
That lama was really just kind of you know just angry and told that no need to ring the gong.
Then nga lama ta yasungis.
And then I went to see him.
Dap. You said, "Don't so that, can't do you are not here. Oh, don't make some of this."
And then I told him that, "Oh, now it is the time. Just may I ring the gong?" And then he said, "No."
Then the new innovation, not nagamin this.
And then I asked that, "Are you sick or what?" Then he said, "No, I'm not sick."
Then the lump too so is he is, the lump too much.
And then I asked, "Did you had some kind of disturbing dream?" He said, "No."
There's there are the land so this year. Then just call a question to the someone.
And then after asking a few questions, then he said, "Oh, you guys are not really respecting me."
Then I thought, "How much question be must they don't send you? Then carry you not here."
And then I told that we all do respect and we just you know try to maintain good discipline.
Then that energy packet is associated. Then Kempo then is okay. Dressing rashi, nidhi shi, then the shi.
And then that the Lama said, well, you know, this Kempo kind of like just cleaning up his throat and just kind of. Like showing up something.
The Quran neyer neki that this is neyer. Ina the human ma chuchu se etu tuse ngaso shegis.
But what to do? He has a kind of you know sickness, and it's naturally happening. And we also told him not make it too loud.
Then. 나서 데레스레 데탐자르시네 데탑쇼지 마치르 순소.
So then again, we just make some commitment to just you know maintain the discipline, and then later he started the teaching.
That's it. Then, teaching huge numbers no, lami kota ni kira she pugu maris kadiyan.
So in that way, just it is also dare not to just you know cough so loudly in front of lama.
Lami jine yaji majil keja tige ha ye maris lama suta yena ye maris.
And then, of course, you know, just in front of Lama, just talking to each other or just, you know, making noise and just going up and down, those are just never existed. So that is why it seems like that when we visit Lama, just one should be kind of more careful.
Lama answer korontene dev kaka yores.
Of course, there is the whole complete book that giving all this lesson how to just relate with a master.
Nasi senori ni amoga na to mumbo yendi ba ndet datsi lami kusan rosa yemar.
So like all this, our conceptual thoughts or afflictive emotions, and with that there is no way to really go near the lama.
Kare sena mo lama le kare kor tiri kare zori matole ronoso poso kitende lesa yemar.
So everything just kind of relate to us to lama, and then one do, there is nothing like one could decide.
Lami tu desen garsona odde rong salamombo jimdo gides.
So even one just disturb little bit of the lama's mind, that which obscures one's path and the bhumis.
Rong so salam da nyam toba ti charma gina garisje de chuchurbas.
So if once one have some actualization with these stages of realization and the path, then after that one can do whatever one wants to do.
Ngase tatu gyo songje ko mon to bi che de lama den ge de lama den lama de ku ku se ku se o den de ge ne de se la de o din ko ne ma thop gu gyo.
So that the ultimate fruition, the Buddhahood, the enlightenment, to obtain that, then we relate and relate to a master, and then one should just kind of respect and just follow in that way, and through that one can receive the blessing, and then there is the benefit. So that the Dharma teaching through which one can attain complete enlightenment is, there is no way that one can buy with the many millions of dollars. Because like if there is happen a little bit of breakage of samayas, then it just kind of obscures for one's own kind of power or realization. So the life force of the Dharma is the just the words of honor, the samaya. So even though you guys are very good, but still that it is good to understand how these things can be just done. So then today there is no any specific classes, so you just carry on with your kind of regular practice and just be kind of happy and broad mind, and then enjoy your practice.
Sonam deye donje zevani tonne ibi donu bose ne seke no jevanu
tuve zebe dole ando kan
do vai tor jenje do de ro agan
do do dam be je dam min ro je ra jen den je go ba
chuma ro be je dan de vai go
san je dam ba da jen je vra jo san je dam je de jen je vra jo nin dan zen do je va
Rongye dunye nanje dhura kyo sewa kanto yanda lam madam dhamme shikye bala lam jujin sadan lam diyen dhira pade lam ikon panjur dhoi shu.
Okay, thank you.